Alright, here we go. A little pan of beans. Just a half batch this time. I'm learning that a half batch is much better on my body. So just a little half batch. And I'm just keeping the uncooked veggies on the sink. I just snack on them. So little bites here and there. All I need is just a little bite of bitterness. That's it. Now, I just need to get myself to having less ketchup and less syrup on these things and get them down to more bitterness so I chew them, chew them longer. That's going to take time, though. What's the main goal, though? Remember, kind of like the sin. When we start describing everything, you know, just keep in mind what the sin is. It's trying to be like the Most High. What's the goal here? We ain't eating meat. No meat. So all these little details and stuff like that are good, you know, trying to get to uncooked food and all that. Trying to get this uncooked food with less sugar stuff in it. Or the cooked food, trying to get the cooked food with less sugary stuff. You know, that's all minor. The main thing, I ain't spending no money on meat, man. No meat. And my body isn't even craving it. That's the main thing. It's satisfied with beans, man. Satisfied good enough. I don't have to take no vitamins, I don't have to take no coral calcium. My eyes don't burn like eating meat, which is drying my eyes out. No cheeses, no sour creams, you know. No dairy stuff. It's regular old pinto beans. Yeah, like the miners. The old day miners in West Virginia used to eat. The old coal miners. Except in today's world, it's going to be silver and gold miners. I better go be digging for silver and gold, man. Living off beans and rice. That digging for silver and gold. Gonna be a new day of miner these days. Be silver and gold miner. Out there with their coin devices, running their coin devices all over the ground, looking for gold and silver. Trying to give me some gold and silver. Start panning for gold and silver, man. Start heading for the rivers. Start looking up the videos about that say gold, you know, how to find gold and stuff like that in the earth, and start getting skilled on that. Silver and gold, how to find it, man. That's what's going to be valuable. Silver and gold. Ah, Tiny. New breed of miner. Mining for silver and gold. Digging here and digging there and digging everywhere. So we might as well all start learning how to dig for silver and gold, how to find silver and gold, man. Because then there's some silver and gold in them there hills somewhere. We just have to be able to find it. So we just start educating ourselves now. Alright, that's good. Yeah, I'll probably have some granola. right, so what's going to be the investment in these times of economic troubles? Shovels and earth picks. Start stocking up, because they're going to be very valuable. Start learning how to start a business with shovels and earth picks. I'm starting mine today. I'm going to start learning how to take some wood and metal and turn it into a shovel. Sell that thing on eBay and Craigslist. That's going to be the business. That's going to be the successful businesses. Those that are going to be in the earth pick and shovel business. In the gold and silver mining businesses. Whee! Might as well start your business today. So, I'm going to look on YouTube. I'm going to start looking up videos, how to dig for gold and silver. That's what we're going to do. How to look for gold and silver. All right, here we go. YouTube. How to dig for silver. There we go. No, we're not looking for how to buy gold and silver. We're looking for how to dig it ourselves. Why buy it from somebody when we can get it free in the earth? I don't see no videos on it. How to dig for gold, then. Nobody gonna teach us how to dig for silver. Someone out there had a video on how to dig for gold. How to dig for gold. Here's a video with a picture of a dog digging in the ground. Gold nugget dig. There we go. Gold nugget dig number one. See? Now, if we own some land, what do? Hire people to go on our land to dig. Give them a part of the dig. Say, whatever you find, you get this much percent. Oh. metal detectors. Because we're going to dig for some heavy metal. Only thing is, Joe, you hire people to dig for gold on our land, right? What happens? Oh, they dig, they find, they pocket 3/4 of it, and they say, this is all I found. And we're like, all right, now before you leave the property, you need to go through here this here metal detector. We're going to see how much gold you have in your bags and in your pockets before you leave. In fact, I have my white metal detector right here. I'm going to just detect all your body. Empty out your pockets, everything. Then they come up with the excuse, oh, that's my metal hip, man. That's my metal hip. Your metal hip goes down to the end of the pocket, huh? Yeah, it does. All right. Empty out the pocket. Pull that pocket out. You have a piece of metal in your butt. What? See, I have metal spine, man. Don't you know they make metal spines these days? I have metal bones in my butt. I have metal bones all over my body. Everything's made of metal, man. All right, gold nugget dig video number 2.